YouTube channel. My name is Priya Mistry, and I'm a general dentist with a practice focused on taking care of patients with TMJ disorders. Today's video will be about the jaw locking open. To understand how the jaw locks open, it's important to have at least a basic understanding of the anatomy of the temporomandibular joint. The temporomandibular joint has two bony components with a little cartilaginous pad of tissue that sits in between those bony components. This pad of tissue serves as a shock absorber or a cushion for the bony components of the joint. The bottom bony component of the joint is the little bony knob that our mandible terminates on, and that is called the condyle. So in reference to this diagram here, the condyle is right here. On top of that is the cartilaginous pad of tissue I was referencing before. It's blue in color in this diagram. On top of that is the temporal bone, or a bone of our skull. The temporal bone itself has two aspects to it that are relevant to the temporomandibular joint. It has the fossa, which is a concavity, and the articular eminence, which is a convexity. So fossa, so a caved in portion essentially, and articular eminence, bony hump essentially. When we go to open our mouths, what happens is the condyle rotates in the fossa, rotates, and then it slides down the articular eminence, and it should not go past the bony hump. It should just stop right at the end of the articular eminence in normal, full opening. When the jaw locks open, that's exactly what happens, is that it does go past the articular eminence. So it goes past and it gets stuck over here. This typically occurs in loose ligamented individuals or individuals with connective tissue disorders, which make them hyperflexible and more prone to this happening. With these individuals, it typically occurs when they're at a concert or on a roller coaster, screaming at the top of their lungs or yawning really big. And after it happens, they're so desperate to seek help that they oftentimes don't even make it to our office. They just go to the emergency room, or they try desperately to maneuver their jaw back into proper alignment. And typically they can do it themselves, or the emergency room doctor can help them. So we don't end up seeing them here, and they don't really need any care from us afterwards, because what they end up doing is functioning at 85 to 90% of their maximum opening capacity. So what that means is when they go to yawn, when they go to bite into a big sandwich or scream on a roller coaster, they will make sure that they never open that big again, because they don't want that to happen again. So they sort of train themselves to not allow this to happen again. And that, my friends, is an open lock. If you liked what you heard or learned something, please click like below and subscribe to my channel. There's more to come, including closed lock, which is a much more common occurrence and much more difficult to treat and manage. Thank you.